Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 65 of the Realm Recap. I am Jason from yakface.com, sort of, and joined again this week is Fly Guy from flyguy.net.
Sort of. No, I'm here all in one piece, so yes, it's a bit of a weird, horrible time for you at the moment, but
yeah.
You've got all your social channels, you know, a lot of people don't even probably know you yet, so there you go.
Yeah. If people want to stay informed and connected and up-to-date on the latest stuff, I am still all over on social media, so Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, that's where you'll find me at most cases when I'm not on the phone with GoDaddy. so
hey, just some sleep maintenance issues. It'll be back.
Yes, it will be back and better than ever.
Indeed.
Maybe. Let's see. This week we will get into the latest news. A few nice things happened this week. We kind of guessed it was going to happen on our last show that Hasbro would reveal their San Diego Comic-Con exclusive, and they did that. It was kind of I would guess the wind kind of got taken out of their sails.
Yeah, a little bit, definitely. Yeah, Viper's Kingdom, I guess.
Viper's Kingdom, and the box leaked a couple days prior on JediInsider.com.
That's right.
And they happened to... Surprisingly, I don't know how they managed to work this out, but they actually have the exclusive in hand, and they posted a YouTube review. Yeah. We'll have a link to that in our show notes, but it's the presentation is really pretty nice.
It is, and the little booklet finally, and a few people were talking to on Twitter. I was really not thinking this was going to be a booklet, but they've actually gone to some length to describe this whole, all the phases of Stormtroopers and little sheets of transfer paper in between just to overlay the differences in the clothes. It's looking really nice, but I mean, ultimately, I think as we discussed on a previous podcast, the Wolfpack, that I mean, it's really likely just going to be cardboard is the only difference. You'll get this trooper, but still nicely done.
Yeah,
looks good, looks solid. Expect lots of repaints.
Yeah, or at least re-accessorized, you know, because I think a lot of the clone troopers look to share, you know, like the sand trooper and stormtrooper and, you know, the original trilogy, there was the base armor and it was modified, you know, like there's the flamethrower trooper that's supposedly, you know, we've seen pictures of it. I guess the snow trooper one as well is a little bit different, I think, but still, this will still provide a good base to action figure. You know, so, and it being repainted chrome, hopefully, for
Phasma,
Phasma, that'll be Phasma, pretty good. So,
it looks good. So, yeah. $24.99, $25.99, was it?
Well, that's kind of weird because Entertainment Weekly posted the reveal of this earlier this week. And in the announcement, they said it's going to be $24.99 available at San Diego Comic-Con and after on Hasbro Toy Shop. And then I think it was yesterday, Hasbro issued, or they notified everyone, hey, the images or new images were up, and there was a press release set with that, and the price then said $25.99. So there's some sort of a weird, I don't know if that's like just a typo or some sort of a convenience fee built into the price there for San Diego, who knows, but it's going to be $25 regardless. So it's not bad for, you know, it's going to be 20 bucks at retail. You're paying an extra $5 for the, I guess, the hassle of trying to get it and the packaging.
Well, I was going to see if you were even fortunate enough to get to buy it at that price, which, let's face it, even those that are getting to go to San Diego Comic-Con, the queues alone, you know, good luck if you can actually really get it at that price, because not a lot of people will, really. But I don't think we added it to the notes, but just even to share that little extra image there from Entertainment Weekly, and we can maybe talk about it later on, but for those that didn't know, I guess there was some other non-Hasbro stuff, but all themed around the First Order Trooper from Lego and Hot Wheels. So yeah, it's very much a First Order Trooper theme coming at San Diego Comic-Con, but the Hasbro one is going to be in demand, that's for sure.
And what's kind of funny, too, you know, they've kind of rolled out all of these First Order Stormtrooper things, as far as, you know, the other ones aren't exclusive to San Diego.
Yep.
But, you know, it was obviously themed around that Stormtrooper. But then, like, when the packaging all comes out in September, it's all going to be Kylo Ren. So it's kind of weird that they, you know...
They went for this.
They went for this, but I guess it's the easiest to do, really. I mean, Army Builder...
It's been seen in the trailers. It maybe can't spoil the movie in some ways.
And they're probably trying to sell the look of the new Stormtroopers, you know, letting people know that, hey, this isn't a clone trooper. This is, you know, the next evolution of the Stormtrooper and whatnot, like the book of it says.
Yep.
So it's a cool, you know, way to go about it, I guess. And it doesn't spoil anything.
That's true.
So
it's been seen. So
pretty smart. Let's see. We talked about this next bit already. Was the review on Jedi Insider regarding the Stormtrooper? But I saw this over on the 6-inch forums over on Facebook. There are bootleg 6-inch figures found in China, and they're really weird.
They are really weird. There's just some photographs, just nice. So,
so the packaging is obviously a complete mess.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's the old, you know, the orange and black style. It's got the Episode 7 foil logo on it.
Yeah. I know.
And then there's the Trimy hole or whatever you want to call it on the front. And it makes the figure light up. There's a video also that you can see.
I think we just got to show. They are weird. But actually highly collectible. I mean, they're very...
Yeah, and there are a few different ones. Mm. There's, you know, Darth Maul, who's, you know, missing half of his face paint, it looks like.
That's right. Bizarre. But, of course, he came as an alternative head. I mean, they went to quite a bit of a degree in packaging there. It's really... Wow. And back to that Stormtrooper. So they're obviously using parts there from the Clone Trooper.
Right.
Meshed with a terrible looking central body and parts from the Sand Trooper and the weapon. So they're getting molds of something and then just making a bit of a hash of it. But
yeah, and that one is called the new role. I mean, what the heck does that mean? You know?
Yeah, I don't know. Don't know.
Like I said, these were found in somewhere in China.
Very bad English, maybe kind of translated across there. So
yeah.
Interesting.
And it's got like a weird like Iron Man hole in the chest that lights up when you push the button. It's like, what the heck does that have to do with Star Wars? I don't know.
Vader makes some sense.
Right.
But Maul? Yeah. I don't know, whatever. So
just something I stumbled across that
very cool
is available out there. There's people that buy this stuff, so.
Oh yeah, definitely.
That's pretty much it for Hasbro this week. There was not a lot of stuff going on with them. Obviously, it was all geared around towards the announcement of their exclusive. So, moving on to Sideshow Hot Toy News. Again, not a whole lot there. They didn't put anything up for pre-order. I'm still waiting for those Jawas to go up. They've been teasing that for several months.
They have, yeah, sometime.
But a couple shows ago, I received notification, and we talked about it, that the ARC Troopers were delayed for a few months to like July, August.
Mm-hmm.
And it was maybe Wednesday, I received an email notification from Sideshow saying that it's going to be available to ship next week for this particular one for Echo. So they must have got their production thing worked out. And so I can expect to receive that soon for people that pre-ordered. It's a nice looking clone. One of the.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Not just a simple repaint. There's a lot of new parts there, you know, from the armor and the pauldrons and helmets and all
that's
the good stuff.
That's a serious pauldron going on there. That's just, it's like Dynasty is back. Okay, wow. He just looks stunning. I love the weathering and the detail that Sage are putting onto these figures these days. They really just up their game, something else.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, cannot wait for. Look at the detail on that. That's phenomenal. Oh. Very excited. Yep. Very excited. Looking forward to them.
So be on the lookout for those very soon if you pre-ordered that. We're going to move on here to other brands and customs for the this week. We touched on it just a little bit ago. LEGO revealed their Force Awakens First Order Stormtrooper that's going to be available as an action figure. It's not really an action figure. It's a buildable figure. I think they're like a 6-inch scale.
That's right. They're kind of... I'll just get this back up.
Kind of techniques or...
Yeah, it's almost like a Bionicle figure. We've seen Cody. I've seen Cody in the flesh at... not Cody in the flesh, sorry. Grievous in the flesh at Celebration. And there was a few others in the cabinets in there. But they're looking particularly good if you're into that kind of thing. Let's see if we can upload a larger image there. But yeah, like it's not for everybody, but I think I'll be a sucker. I'll have to get that. So they look pretty good. So interesting. And they should be around the $20-$25 price point. So
right. And this won't be available. This is not an exclusive to San Diego, so people don't have to worry about trying to track that down. There'll be another exclusive that they'll probably have for Star Wars, but this is just something they're going to have on display, and they'll be showing that off, and it's not going to be available for sale until January. So,
kind of consistent with the Hasbro one in the terms of two blasters on the figure, one on the belt and one on the hand. So,
right.
Interesting.
Pretty cool. Let's see what else. We might as well talk about that Hot Wheels one too. It's not in our show notes, but it's part of their whole launch here.
And that's nice.
I like the look of that.
Very swish indeed. I do love when they do that big art on the card. It just that's the attracting factor for me personally. But yeah, that's nice.
Changed up the design, from the other ones. You know, it had the most of them had like the bluish background with the red and yellow Star Wars logo. This has just the white, which is going to be on the, the Kylo Ren packaging.
Yep.
Just the white logo. Yep. So it looks nice as a presentation.
Yep.
The car itself looks a lot like the other Stormtrooper car that came out.
It does. Very similar. I noticed the blaster is on the side of there. Again, the kind of...
Yeah, pretty nice though. If you're into those cars, still those character cars.
Hopefully, on the back of that, we'll get some of the concept art. I love some of the Hot Wheels concept things that they have. They're beautiful. They're very nice. If you've never seen them, but
right, again, that car is not exclusive to San Diego. That'll be available there for purchase, I think, and then it's also going to be available at retail. So it's not like you're trying to track that one down special, because last year they had the Darth Vader car that came in like the lightsaber case or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that did all that well as to why they're not having an exclusive like that this year, but
it was pricey, I think, from memory.
The
Vader car wasn't cheap for something that eventually ends up being what, $4.99, $3.99, something like that.
All right.
So yeah.
Let's see, next bit here. Entertainment Earth announced they're having another exclusive Funko Hakari figure. This is the Infrared Vader, I believe, is what it's called. Reminds me a lot of the Lava Vader that came out when Revenge of the Sith hit theaters. It was an exclusive to Target.
That's right. Limited to 500, this one, so... surprisingly still available. So these things normally when the low runs send it pretty quickly. But again, there's been a few Vaders already, I think.
There was the lightning one.
That's right.
That's the only one I remember. Okay. I don't think they've released regular one, like just a straight up Vader.
Mm. Okay.
I've seen pictures of it, but I have never seen it offered up for solicitation or sale yet. So anyway, if people are into those, that's where you can get it. Funko also announced another exclusive, I think it's exclusive, K-3PO, the white protocol droid.
No, it wasn't exclusive.
No.
I remember that one. So no, but it is pre-sold out. That's bizarre. Vader not sold out, 500. K-3PO, 750, pre-sold out. That's
maybe people just don't like the weird colors, because this one here is pretty traditional coloring. It's representative of what it is in the film. Vader obviously wasn't. So maybe that may be the selling factor there. I don't know.
Yes. Interesting. I'd love to know your thoughts. If you're watching the show, leave a comment below. We'd what do you like about Hikari? So yeah, that'd be interesting.
And cool. Another Funko bit here was they brought another figure out of the quote unquote Funko vault, the Pop Gamorrean Guard.
Cute little, that's right, yes. Cute
little pig.
He is very cool little guy. So I can't even remember when he came out the first time, but I love the teeth. And yeah, you can pre-order him right now. So he's available. So yeah, looking good.
Not bad. Speaking of vinyl-y type figures, over on Vinylmation World, they revealed that next week Disneyland and Disney World are going to have a Vinylmation Chewbacca available. This will be similar to how they've done in the past, where basically it's, again, it's blind box. You're getting the like a standard Chewbacca, the one that's on the left there. If you're watching the video version of this, it looks just pretty, you know, it's just regular Chewbacca. Mm-hmm. I think the one on the right is going to be a chase version that will be available in, you know, certain, I don't know what the ratio breakdown is, but not everyone will be able to get the Chewbacca from Jabba's Palace.
That's going to be tough to get, yes.
Yeah. So
I like the use of the ears as the archway from inside Jabba's Palace. Clever. Right. Clever. Very clever.
Yeah. I know these little Vinylmation things aren't for everyone, but there's a following out there for them. I like some of them. I picked up a set this week, to be honest. They're just fun. I think they're filling the niche that Kubrick had for me, because I was a big Kubrick Star Wars collector, and that line completely died. And I didn't like the bears, ironically, the bear brick versions of the Star Wars figures. But these, I don't know, there's some sort of an attraction there. I can't really place it. It's maybe
each to their own. Everybody likes something different in Star Wars, that's for sure.
What else? This was a image that popped up on my Twitter feed. This was the packaging for the upcoming PlayArts Kai variant Boba Fett figure. I thought you would like that.
Stunning. Yes, I saw this. I actually saw it in a different tweet with some other figures. There was other PlayArts Kai. It was Batman or Spider-Man or something. Spider-Man and Iron Man, that's what it was.
Yeah, that Iron Man is pretty sweet looking.
Yeah, the black one. Yeah, they look really good. So, yes, very, very interested in this. So, going to be tough to get. This one's pre-sold out, and it's kind of hard to get. So, yeah.
Yeah, these are about 100 plus, yeah. Right?
Absolutely, 120,
10-inch figures.
Yep, yep. So, yes, very much in demand. But coming kind of soon, I think, if I remember, late July, they should be around, coming from Japan. So, yeah, can't wait to get this one. Cool.
What else? There was, we'll move on to some of the custom news this week. Hole in the Ground Productions sent out a notification that he has a new project available for order. It's what he's calling the Ball Speeder from A New Hope.
And it looks great painted. It really does.
Yeah, it comes with those little decals over there you see on the right-hand side. So you can do it up pretty nice.
It's excellent.
$45, custom, you know.
Yeah. Hey, looks great with a cantina diorama. That's the...
Yeah. It's, Walrus Man taking a... Looks like he's in a hot tub.
I was going to say...
Hot tub time machine.
Walrus tub machine. Yes, very cool. We only saw the unpainted version the week before, but it looks really nice. I really dig this.
A lot. It looks very kind of Star Trek almost on the inside for some
reason.
It does.
It does, the colors and the shape.
Kirk's chair, maybe.
Yeah. Well, you need to travel around Mos Eisley in an air-conditioned environment, so this is what you use. So, kind of cool.
Yep. Let's see. Last little bit of custom news here this week. Brandon Flores, who we've talked about several times on several previous shows, he's got a new project in the works. Yeah. A 6-inch scale X-Wing. So we've shared his, you know, TIE Fighter Interceptor a couple shows ago. He was working on a land speeder. I'm not sure his progress on that. It was pretty far along, but he's got this thing and it's looking huge.
I know. He works so fast. I mean, literally the other day, all I saw him was having two huge rulers
Yeah.
as the measurement. And then all of a sudden now we have this. I mean,
yeah.
wow, and it's all weathered and burn marks and battle marks and wow. I don't know how he does it, but the man's a machine, so cannot wait to see the size of the thing. What a huge scale it's going to be in. I think it was his daughter or his kid that you had holding some of the rulers and the size of it. Mm-hmm. So, Brandon, you must have a huge home.
Yeah. Pretty cool.
He's got a little hole in the ground production thing in the background there.
That's right.
So, very cool. So, major customizer. So, yes, very cool. Giant size X-Wing for your Black Series.
Yes. This last little bit here was something you had brought to my attention. I didn't even notice I was tagged on it on Instagram the other day, but this Instagram person, Venomous, did a nice illustration of the two of us. I'm very impressed with the artistry of it. It's like I'm trying to recognize myself there. It's like, man, my face looks fat.
I think it's just the hood and the way the beard. Yeah. He's taking some renders, I think.
It's great. I really like it. I pass it off along to my brothers and my dad, and they're like, oh my God, that's awesome. You know, they were.
I know.
Pretty jazzed.
I rock, man. I love that. I've got a whole Boba Fett outfit and the whitest teeth in the galaxy. I'm like, go for it.
Some nice dental work. And my beard is, you know, kind of like how it once was.
I know, but.
Trying to get that back, but yeah.
Venice, he's been around for a while. I remember him from some Tumblr days, and mm-hmm. he's a very talented artist. And I shared some other stuff that he done. I shared the post that I made about him, but I love some of his work. He's got a really distinctive style, and his First Order troopers there, flamethrower troopers, just blew me away. But
yeah,
very talented artist. Eli, what's his son name? I completely forgot his son name, but Eli, you do an amazing job. So. Great artist. You should follow him. He's got some great, great stuff. Nice sense of humor as well. And I love his styly stuff. His Darth Plagueis comic. He was talking about that before.
Yeah, I saw that across my feed one day.
Yeah,
whoa, is this a new comic? And I had to read that. No, it was just something.
I thought it was as well. So there he is himself at Star Wars Celebration. I missed him. I never even got to meet him either. So there you go. So thank you, Venomous, for watching the show and sharing your awesome artwork. And in return, we're sharing yours. So there you go. It's love all around.
Very cool. I was pretty thrilled with that. So let's see. Moving on to TV, movie, book, and game news. This week, we learned of the passing of Christopher Lee, who obviously we all know played Count Dooku, but famous for hundreds of other roles.
Including Police Academy, Attack on Moscow, that film that we'll all remember. And all. It's true. Actually, he was in that movie. But, he was something else. He was a real talent. If anyone watches some of the behind-the-scenes stuff for Lord of the Rings movies, he's just – it's great to see him at such an old age just doing some amazing stuff.
Yep.
There he goes in that fight scene. Very cool.
Because he was in his 70s during the filming of Attack of the Clones. So,
and you wouldn't have thought, I wouldn't have thought it. I didn't realize until afterwards. So and they handled these scenes flawlessly with someone else. But yeah, Count Dooku is no more. So he really did bring a kind of gravitas to those movies that in some cases, a lot of new actors, it needed something like that. It needed the Alec Guinness kind of component. And,
yep.
Boy, he was it. So, yeah. Had a good run at 93 years old. So,
right. Yeah, it was announced, I think, just yesterday that he had passed, but he had passed away, I think, the week prior. You know, they were still, I think they were waiting to confirm, you know, and notify all of his, I'm sure, extensive family, being 93. Yep. So, yeah, that went up yesterday. And I gathered up a bunch of some collectibles I have for him and, snapped a nice image and shared it across our social media channels. It's kind of fun gathering up some of that stuff to photograph.
So we've got Clone Wars hologram version. This one is from Legacy Clone Wars. That's a great one there.
The Evolutions one.
Yeah. That's the little Kinder Egg, if I'm not mistaken. You've got a few, I've forgotten the name.
Spider pods.
Spider pods.
Yeah.
Is that, that's the Gentle Giant bust?
No, that's the 12-inch Hasbro.
Oh, so it is. I can see the legs, but I thought it was on the shelf there.
Yeah.
What is this one? I can't
that's
remember.
That's the Hasbro Unleashed figure.
I thought that was a prototype, you'd said, no? Oh, okay.
No, the artwork that I shared on Twitter was prototype art.
And the Kubrick, I had that too.
Yep.
That the one mini one. Busts as well, the little micro busts?
Yeah, bust ups from Gentle Giant, I believe. And then obviously the lightsaber from Master Replicas.
It's a good little collection you got there, sir.
Yeah.
That Hasbro 12 inch is really fantastic on the facial sculpt.
Very much so. It has, it's one of the more, it had a very unique body that they used for that. It had really articulated hands, you know, where it had finger articulation.
Wow. Okay. That's unusual.
And obviously, like you said, the likeness was just spot on. I think right after, like, it was during that saga line of 12 inch, that's when the license got passed to Sideshow. So
very good. Very good indeed.
What else? Disney Infinity confirmed and officially took the wraps off of their Rebels figures that are coming to that game system.
That's right. They look incredibly cool. We talked about these briefly on last night's Wolfpack, but the quality of the posing and the dynamics, I'm just waiting for this piece to come up. Just 1 second. But the posing and the quality of them, they just look fantastic. We got it. Mm-hmm. You got to buy these. People are going to be buying these in droves. So, lots of information on there, but the images of them look great. And as you pointed out, Ezra has his scar from his duel with the Inquisitor there, but great little pose with his very cool lightsaber.
Right.
Kanan. Quite accentuated head on him there, but
yeah, it's got the still elongated horse face, kind of.
It is, isn't it? It's very kind of accentuated. Sabine, I'm surprised that's not her helmet, but still cool.
Yeah, and again, that's her season 2 look with her new blue hair.
That's right.
And upgraded armor.
But that's Zeb. A good one, Zeb. Just the pose.
I thought Ab. Zeb was flipping the bird there when I first looked at the image. It's like, come here.
Yeah. No. But yeah, they're coming out.
These figures are great.
They are good. Very good indeed. And this is only the beginning. Oh boy, we need deep pockets. But yeah, there's some more sketches and information on the show notes.
Okay. Just 1 second. If you could take the show for a second, I have to step out of the room for a minute.
No problem. We'll talk about some Lando stuff.
Sounds awesome. Right back.
And that was the covers for the brand new Marvel comic. There's quite a pile of them. The many collectible covers for Lando's comic. So number one, we get a John Tyler Christopher cover. Let's just explode this up a little bit. And open it up. So if you've been collecting all the collectible action figure covers, then this is one you definitely want to get. The Lando cover, looking awesome. Do you like that one indeed? Great little pose and a nice little nod back to the vintage collection there with the cape that never really sat on him properly, but very cool. Some other inside sketches there of what the comic will look like, and Lobot's obviously a key character. We've got the Scotty Young cover, which is rather cool. I love this one. I don't know whether you get a chance to see it. This kind of magazine cover that's going on here.
Reminded me of TV Guide or something.
Maybe that's what they're going for. I don't know. And I don't know the names of the artists on these ones exactly, but there is details in the source. And this was thought to be the original cover, but it's not. This, even though it doesn't say variant on it, apparently this is not the core cover. Sketch like cover, and there's one other one that I shared in my notes, which as far as I can tell is the de facto cover, which is this one, the Royal Guard version there. So we'll find a bit more, but this actually wasn't included in the comic book resource source that I linked to there, but this one wasn't included there, so I don't know quite what's going on, but often these covers can change right up until the very last minute. So,
who was the artist that does the action figure variant covers?
John Tyler Christopher.
I think he's doing that that TV Guide cover as well, you know, that we were just talking about. I think that's him as well.
Wouldn't surprise me. So, just trying to look here at the details. Yeah, I think you're right, actually. I think that's his little signature mark down at the bottom. Don't see the other one, but we'll find it soon enough.
Yeah.
But, man, they're cool and they're collectible. So, yeah, more comics for me. So, any one of these jump out to you that you really want, apart from the action figure one, I guess?
Just the Lando action figure cover.
I do like the Scotty Young one. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's more comics are coming.
Let's see what else. This one was something you added, Tops goodies to give away.
Yeah, some good stuff. The nice, very nice people at Tops have, just to celebrate the kind of recent Empire Strikes Back illustrated set of which our good friend Dan Curto has maybe not been involved in this particular set, but he's going to be involved in the Force Awakens set. So you can win some of these. All you got to do is follow us on Instagram. There's links in the show notes here to this little post, but it's a very cool little features in this. It's not only just the Empire Strikes Back movie, but it goes a little beyond and before. This is a before shot of Boba Fett. There's a little bit of stories and backgrounds, but film sales and panorama cards and all the usual really cool, interesting little collectibles. But you can win one. So just get on and follow the show notes and follow us on Instagram and you can get it. I love that little sketch of Yoda there, that classic Macquarie art, I think it was, that's then been stylized here further. So cool. Very addicted to these trading cards right now. Thank you for...
Yeah. No problem.
Let's see
what else. There was an announcement by Lucasfilm, well, I guess it would have been ILM, that they're developing a new kind of like a virtual reality system.
Did you get a chance to watch this video? I guess you did.
I did.
Pretty damn impressive. They've shown some of this. They showed clips maybe 6 months or so ago before, just sharing some of this on screen.
Yes. ILM XLab.
A very 3D immersive world where, and the clip comes up. Let me see if we can forward to the sequence. It was a sequence they showed. This is the one that they'd shown previously before, where they had a stormtrooper, a sand trooper, there we go, and Tatooine, and they could dynamically change the background and the weathering and add elements. And they've just expanded it further. And there seems to be a lot of development these days from, well, Facebook bought Oculus Rift and Google launched a kind of 3D kind of system like this as well. So yeah, they're really pushing the technology, but to see ILM involved in this is quite something else. So
yeah,
very much next gen consoles, I think, but very, very cool indeed. So
yeah, it's like you're stepping right into the whole world, you know, where you're able to interact with, you're able to take on the characteristics of a Star Wars character like C-3PO and be able to walk around in, like, in his shell, basically, or other, you know, like you said, stormtroopers, and it's just kind of a pretty cool technology, and it shows how advanced, you know, things are. Like, how does that, you know, work into the film world? Like,
yeah,
you could film scenes. Oh, this person isn't available this day, or this, you know, stormtrooper actor isn't available this day, so you're just gonna have someone else step in, do a quick render, and then that gets inserted into the movie somehow. You know, it just seems like it'd be that easy.
Well, the CG, I mean, I just went to see Jurassic World the other night, and it's flawless nowadays. They just, you just can't tell. It's getting harder and harder to tell what's, obviously it's a dinosaur, but some of the aspects are very real in some of the effects. So,
right.
Yeah, technology is moving on.
Let's see. Last night, you and I were both on the Wolfpack podcast, where we kind of broke down, you know, some of the things we had discussed here, but also some other stuff for Star Wars weekends and whatnot. So, if people are interested in that show, they can you can subscribe to their channel, of course, and listen and watch episode 144.
Exactly. Good little show indeed.
Let's see. Star Wars Celebration, or not Celebration, San Diego Comic-Con panels. You had added that to the show notes?
Yeah. Just, again, this is something in case anybody missed it, but both Hasbro and Star Wars officially in their capacity, Kathleen Kennedy, J.J. Abrams, all announced panels at Star Wars, both covering books. We're showing this just on screen just now, and again in the show notes. Publishing, the Hasbro panel, 12 to 1 on the Friday, and more information about collectibles, EFX, the usual kind of thing, where Gentle Giant, Kotobukiya, Saito, etc. Every year they always give a little bit of a reveal, but it's turning into Star Wars Day at San Diego Comic-Con, so don't know quite how I'm supposed to queue for the figure and go to these panels, but that's a nice challenge to have, but we'll let you know how that goes. And ILM's 40th anniversary, which is kind of phenomenal. Obviously, ILM had to be around prior to the A New Hope. 40 years for a company to be going, it's pretty spectacular. So, and Disney Infinity, there's going to be some reveals there and some, I'm guessing, more playable consoles and whatnot. So, lots happening on the Friday of San Diego Comic Con.
And I think they said that people that attend that particular panel are going to be able to see possibly some new footage from The Force Awakens, not a new trailer, but just some
sequence or something. Yeah,
could be. So I think people are going to be clamoring and queuing to get into that panel.
Well, it's often, I mean, even IMAX theaters right now, I believe there's a 6 minute, or is it 6 or 8 minutes, 6 or 8 minutes preview for Ant-Man.
Right.
Still already out, so it could well be something like similar to that. Maybe not necessarily a new trailer, but it might be. Who knows? But either way, you're going to find it soon enough. StarWars.com will post it on the YouTube channel, and both Yakvies and Blaga and everyone else will post it, so you'll get to see it pretty quick. So.
Yeah. Let's see. The last thing this week regarding the game news portion, Star Wars Battlefront Deluxe Edition.
Yeah, I take it you got to see this. I just love the artwork on the helmets here that was shared out on Twitter. Manabite was the one that I'd seen it on. I think you shared it as well. But
yes.
Well, that's where I saw it. I can't remember. But the love the helmet designer. This is the deluxe edition. So little extras and virtual goodies that you get with the pack. But nice artwork there. You get to see the details inside just that Trooper's eye. So both for Xbox One and PlayStation 4. So,
pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it. I mean, I'm not a huge gamer. I think I've said that before, but just the realism of this game looks to be something. I mean, it's kind of funny. I think I lost you there.
Sorry, just for some sound.
Oh, sorry. I was saying that I think the realism of this game, like I said, I'm not a big gamer, but it makes me want to play.
For sure. Yeah. Well, it was kind of like the last ones. I mean, there's a certain, we thought it was good then, so it's even better now. So, if you get this deluxe edition, I guess you get a pre-order. You get little goodies, virtual goodies, DL-44 blaster, grenades, torpedoes, all that stuff that people seem to love these days. So, I go into the game normally to look around and enjoy the scenery, and and these kind of things blow the crap out of me. So,
right.
Nice.
Let's see. Reviews this week. I had none because I have no site to post them to at the moment. But you had a few, a couple of nice previews of some upcoming stuff that should be shipping out here really quickly.
It's shipping out right now, so if you've from Darkside Toys, certainly anyway, I don't know about other e-tailers or retailers when they're going to get them or not. I believe some places around the country are getting Wampas, but not necessarily, Tauntauns, not necessarily Wampas, but Darkside are shipping. They all should probably be finished, I would imagine, if you've not got yours by Monday, it will be sent out by then. But the Wampa is particularly cool. I'm looking around for a real-life version of them. But I do love them. I really do like them. I don't know if this is one you're going to get or not, but
I do like that.
Classic style, the articulation, the kind of tiers that they've got them. They've kind of done them like chewy and just, again, that removable arm, the kind of meat effect on the other side. It's just a really nice job. I think they've done a really good design job, and I think it's one of those figures that they've just had some real passion about, and he's mega articulated, even great rocking ankles. And yeah, just when you think back of the old one we had where his arms just went up like that, and
I know.
So yeah, things have changed, so it's very cool.
So, yeah, that one was four POA, I think, because he couldn't POA, move his head.
Exactly. So there was that, and the Hoth look, which I don't have to hand. I do. I think, in fact, he's in a little baggy. But he's particularly cool. Nice little features and touches and lightsaber, and there's nothing wrong with him at all. He's just probably not the most exciting figure for me, but he looks good with the Wampa. So
great.
Yeah.
Let's see. New toy acquisitions and purchases this week. I had a few things. I think I talked about a couple of them last week, but I did get them this week. Let's see. I received from Dorkside Toys my Revoltech Boba Fett, which I'm very happy with. I've opened it, and I haven't futzed around with it too much, but man, it's a nice figure.
It is a nice figure. I've never seen so many people say how happy they are with that figure. The Twitter feed was exploding this week with people sharing pictures, and yep. Oh my God, this figure's really, really good. So yeah.
Yeah. Here's maybe really a better shot of the box, you know, getting a sample of what the articulation and detail is like, you know, because the glare on the other side of the box doesn't really show that, but yeah, it's.
Yeah. I'm going to break one open and give it a review as well. Cause it's Boba. Got to be done.
Yes. I showed this last week, the Ashigaru Stormtrooper. I love that thing. I have it on my desk. It's just the style and the, like we talked about, the color of the armor and just the articulation and everything. I just can't get enough of these. I need to get another one, to be honest.
He's very, very cool. Yeah, I do.
So I have a couple on display because he has so many options as far as the switch out fists, and he's got the sword, and he's got like the flintlock pistol. It's, I don't know. Yeah. It's just one of those things that.
He looked cool in the pictures, but again, when I'd say this the last show, but when I saw this thing in the flesh at Celebration, that was instantly right there. I stopped and I ordered it. It's that cool. It's so good. So yeah, very smart figure.
Oh yes. What else? I got that Vinylmation Star Wars Rebels set, which includes a little Vinylmation chopper and little Zeb. Kind of there. He's angry. I like these things a lot. Let's see what else. There was a Inquisitor one that went on sale yesterday, I think. I picked that up online, so that's on the way. So
cool.
Got that, and I think. Corey, actually, from the Wolfpack Podcast picked this up for me. And he also got me one of those cool Force Awakens, Force United, or not Force United, Force for Change pins.
Force for Change.
That has the First Order Stormtrooper on it. So.
Oh, a little lag there. Oh, back.
Yep. So that was it for me.
That was it for you.
Yeah.
Comics. I think I got a pile of comics this week. I shared a few Instagrams of them. Iron Man and some Star Wars and John Tyler Christopher. Just about six different versions came at once. I picked up these on Fleabay from a very nice seller. There's only 100 packs of these made available. They were a bugger to get at Celebration. Mm. They're oversized trading cards, and this was the Boba Fett set. And there's like 5 cards in the pack. But it was for this particular one, which I just cannot get on the Star Wars card trader app for love nor money.
I know.
So I bought the damn thing. So in real life rather than the digital version. But really nice little set, just reproducing them. And the fact there was only 100 made, and it was pretty cheap. So another one was, again, trading cards have just became something for me, which is a dangerous path to go down. But little Iron Man trading cards. These are Chase trading cards that originally came out with Iron Man 2, the movie. And saw them when I said, it was actually $3. But the backs are beautifully presented with a little chrome side down them. And they basically reproduce old classic Iron Man art. And just love them. I am just getting just worse with Iron Man. It's on par with Star Wars. So I think, again, like $3 or $4 ships. So there's some really nice bargains out there. Nice, cool collectibles. If you really hone your focus, I think sometimes you can dig out some really cool collectibles. So that was me.
Well, I think with that, that wraps up this week's show. We'd like to thank everyone, as always, for watching and sharing and commenting. We had a lot of good responses and shares last week for last week's show and the previous show. So, again, thanks, everyone, for that. We will be back, I think, next week. I'm not sure if there's anything going on with you or I as far as our schedules go, but I think we should be good to go. Awesome. We will see you all again next time. Thanks for watching.
See ya.